This is a shear for the Talmidim of Yeshiva Gdeila of Miami and anybody else who wants to join. And the shear is going to be about two inyonim that we do nowadays by the Seder and to discuss how was it done with Masha B'Samigash HaYekayim. And this is first negating the inyon of Morer, and then we're going to talk a little bit about the meaning of the Shnei Tavshilin that we put on the Kaira. It says in the Morah Psochim, Daf Kuf Ches Amud Beis. Omar Rava, Rava said, Matzah bizman hazeh deraiseh morer derabonon. Matzah bizman hazeh is still medaraiseh, even though bizman hazeh we don't have bizamikdash. Morer is derabonon. The Gemara asks, Umayishno morer, what is the reason why is morer not deraiseh nowadays? Because the Ksiv, it says, Al matzeh sebreirim dichlu, it says you should eat it, meaning the Korban Pesach, together with matzeh morer. Which means that Isman the Ike Pesach Yash Morer. If there is a Korban Pesach, there is Morer. Isman the Leke Pesach Leke Morer. And when there is no Korban Pesach, there is no Morer. So based on that Pesach, we understand that if there's no Korban Pesach, Isman Azeh, there's no mitzvah of Morer from the Pesach, from the Torah. But the question the Gemara asks, Matzah Namo, Ksiva Matzah Shem Reim Rachlu. So why is Matzah Midaraisa? Since the Pesach says, Matzah Shem Reim Yichlu, that means that you have to eat the Matzah with the Korban Pesach, so that if you don't have a Korban Pesach, we shouldn't have the mitzvah of Matzah. And the Gemara answers, Matzah miheder hodre beikro v'erev techo matzah. Matzah, there's another posik. Besides this posik, of matzah zemreim yechlu, there's another posik, v'erev techo matzah. And that posik doesn't connect the matzah to the Pesach. So there's a special mitzvah, an independent mitzvah of eating matzah. But by morer, there's no other posik that tells us about the mitzvah of morer. It's just a posik, al matzah zemreim yechlu, so it's connected to the Korban Pesach, that you have to eat the Korban Pesach with the Morer, so therefore, if there's no Korban Pesach, there is no Morer. And that's how the Poskim write. And to use the Alter Rebbe's Loshon in Shulchan Aruch, Simen Tov Ayin Hei Sif Tesvov, this is the Loshon. Mitzvahs Morer min HaTorah Eine Ela Bizman Shar Pesach Nechal. The mitzvah of Morer Midaraisi is only when the Korban Pesach was eaten. Shenemer, as it says in Baleischo, Amatzah Shem Redim Yichlu. But you should eat it, the Korban Pesach, with Matzah Morer. Abu Bizman HaSeh Eine Ela Medibri Seifrim. But nowadays, the mitzvah of Morer is only with the Rabbanon. She'tiknu zeicher le'migdash. They made it as a zeicher to the Mikdash. Since by the Mikdash they ate Morer, so nowadays, even though we don't have the Korban Pesach, we still have to eat Morer with the Rabbanon as a zeicher. Aval achilas matzah v'lai lo'arishin, avis man hazeh u'nateira. But eating matzah, even nowadays, it's midaraiser. Shnemar, because the Pesach says, v'erev toich l'matzes, the evening of Pesach, we should eat matzes, v'lai husker shon Pesach. But the Korban Pesach is not mentioned in this Pesach, so there's a separate mitzvah of eating matzah. And later on, Alter Rebbe again quotes this, like a Sif Yitzayin, he says, Abishet bizman hazeh morer einu l'madivre seifrim u'matzeh min ha-Torah. Morer bizman hazeh es d'rabbanan and matzeh in the Torah. The way it looks superficially, the way people learn it superficially, it seems to say that from here we learn out that the whole inyan of morer is only, we call it a machshir to the Pesach. It's only a condition in the Korban Pesach. In other words, the morer is eaten only as something together with the Korban Pesach. And therefore, if you're not eating the Korban Pesach, so there's no mitzvah of morer, because the whole mitzvah of morer is only to be part of what the Korban Pesach is. But that is not true. Because the truth is that even in the time when you're not eating the Korban Pesach, and actually you're not mechuyev to eat the Korban Pesach, mitzvah morer would be min ha-Torah. When is that? In the time of the Beis HaMikdash, when a person did not eat the Korban Pesach because he was not mechuyev. And there are different conditions when a person is not mechuyev. Especially if he was tomei. A person was tomei, was not allowed to eat the Korban Pesach. A person was bederech rechayka. A person was far away from the Azore, and he couldn't bring the Korban Pesach. So he didn't eat the Korban Pesach al-Pedin. Al-Pedin was not allowed to eat the Korban Pesach. Nevertheless, the mitzvah of morer for him to eat was min ha-Torah. Means, when it says the Loshon in Shulchan Aruch and in the Poskim, that mitzvahs morer min ha-Torah eino ela bizman sha-Pesach nechal, it's only at the time when the Korban Pesach was eaten. And then it says, aval bizman hazeh eino ela medivrei seifrim, but nowadays it's only medivrei seifrim, only med rabbanon. It means lizman hazeh, it means actually zman hazeh, when there is no Beis HaMikdash. But when we had a Beis HaMikdash, they were chayev to eat morer, even if you didn't bring the Korban Pesach. But for instance, a tomei or a bederech rechayka. And therefore it comes out, when the Alter Rebbe writes, mitzvahs morer min ha-Torah ein el bizman sha-Pesach nechal. The mitzvah morim with the rice is only when the korban pesach was eaten. It's interesting. It doesn't say the mitzvah of morim with the rice was only when you ate it together with the korban pesach. Then it would mean that if you're not eating a korban pesach, there's no mitzvah of morim with the rice. He says it's only bisman sha pesach nechal, losh nifal. The pesach was eaten. Eaten not by him, eaten by others. That means if there is a metzias of korban pesach, that means the Bisham Mikdash is there and there's a chiv of korban pesach, everybody has to eat morim in HaTorah. Not only those that are actually eating the korban pesach, even those that are potter from the korban pesach, they're still chayv to eat morim in the raisa. It's only bisman hazeh, when there is no korban pesach, bichlal, then it's only with the Besoiker. And actually this is mafurish clear in the Teisefte, in the end of the second Perek, which the Rebbe in the Haggadah on the Pisket Sofen, Rebbe quotes that Teisefte, as I'll mention it soon. The Tesefta says like this: Hachazeres va'amatzah va'pesach einu makin zeh. The morer and the matzah and the korban pesach don't hold up one of each other. In other words, they're independent. You could each mitzvah separately. What does that mean? We know that the korban pesach is ma'akiv morer. So the Minchas Bikurim explains what the Rice said that Tesefta means. He says like this: This is the lashon. The heicha deleke pesach chayiv v'matzah morer. If there is no korban pesach, you're still chayiv matzah morer. The ksiv be'erev teichlo matzis. By matzah it says be'erev teichlo matzis. Uhadi morer, he says. Morer is also midaraisa, even if there's no korban pesach. So the korban pesach is not makiv the morer. But he says, umayred bizman de chayiv be'pesach. It's talking about a time when you chayiv, not this person, but bechlal your chayiv be'pesach. Rak, shehu tameh, that he was tameh, he doesn't have a pesach, so he's mechuyiv. Morer with the raisa. The chayiv he says mamatzah morer. Then other example he gives a orl or a benechor with the Torah's mamayit. It says kol orl lo yechal bay, kol benechor lo yechal bay. That an orl or a benechor is not allowed to eat from the korban pesach. So we darshan bay ein eichel. He doesn't eat from the korban pesach. Aval eichel bematzah morer. He can't eat the korban pesach, but the pasuk is telling you that he has to eat matzah and morer. Aval bisman de leke pesach. Only a time when there is no korban pesach bechlau. Kegeno idno like nowadays, then morer is the rabbanon, the iskesh lepesach, it was connected to Pesach. So therefore, bisman the leke Pesach, leke morer. So there's no Pesach, bechlal, there is no morer. Only in matzah it says yuchayi, because it says berev teichu matzah. Now according to this, it's negated to another halacha. The Alter Rebbe says, in the same siman in Sifta Zion, lefichoch, in korach odem kazayis matzah v'kazayis morer, v'lo asan yachad v'ochlom, a person takes together matzah and morer and eats them together. Bizman hazeh leyotze yidei chivosei. So bizman hazeh, you're not yotze the mitzvah of matzah, even though you ate the matzah with the morer. Why? Shamorer shumedivri sofrim bevatles hatam matzah shumed haTorah. The morer is the rabbanon, and the matzah is the raisa. So if you eat the two together, so the tam of the morer, which is the rabbanon, is mevatel the tam of the matzah, which is the raisa. But he says that's only bisman hazeh when the morer is the rabbanon. Apo bisman she bisamigdash hayakayim shamorer rugam kimen haTorah. In time the bisamigdash morer was also in haTorah. Yotzo yidei chevas matzah yidei chevas morer. His yotzo also the mitzvah of matzah, even if he ate them together in the time of the bisamigdash. Why? Because since then it was the raisa. It's a mitzvah shel Torah. Ein mevatel zu vezu. Two mitzvahs, the raisa, are not mevatel one another. Sheshkulin hen ka'achas, they're both equal. Sheshkulin kiyim mitzvah yisuf shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and all fulfilling the Eibush Hazrotzim. So therefore, bisman she bisamigdash hayakayim, and you ate the matzah and the morer together, you're yotze matzah because of both the rice. But now when we said that it's lav dafke when you ate the korban pesach, even if you didn't eat the korban pesach, bisman habayis, morer is the rice. So it comes out that when he says here that morer is the rabbonon, and if you eat morer and matzah together, you're not yotze matzah, it's only bisman hazeh mamish when there is no bisamigdash. But if he did this in the time of the bisamigdash, let's say somebody was talking about the Chacheka, which didn't need the Korban Pesach, is Mekayim, if ate the Matzah Morer together, Mekayim, the Mitzvah of Matzah, and the Mitzvah of Morer. Why? Because even then, Morer is the Raisa, and two Mitzvahs, the Raisa, are not battle one another. Actually, this is what the Rebbe writes with Feirish. I'm not saying any Chidushim, the Rebbe writes with Feirish in Agoda, in the piece at Agoda and Sofun. He writes like this, in the Gaya, the eating of Afakim, and he writes like this, in Shulchan Aruch, Kosov, Shulchan Aruch writes, one is for the zeicher of the Pesach, and one is the zecher for the matzah that's eaten with the Korban Pesach. And the Rebbe taught Jesus. Actually, in the first Hitzah of the Agodah, this was the end of the piece. There was nothing more to this piece. Later, when the Rebbe wrote Miluyim, Hashlomis, or whatever they call it, Hisophis, he added from here till the end of the whole paragraph there. Pirush, he taught Jesus. Yesh neshtei deyes, there are two opinions. Shekazai safekemen hu zecher the Pesach, eshu zecher the matzah, shenachelo zema Pesach ala seva. So machleik is 2 days, whether it's the zecher to the Pesach itself, or it's the zecher to the matzah with the Pesach. And therefore, lo says, if they stay on table, they say him to be yitzibot, it's good to eat to zaysim. Then the Rebbe added now that labdafki, you have to eat to zaysim, you could eat it, and the kavanah in your mind should be that this should be according to whichever shita is right. Anyway, that's nothing good. And then the Rebbe asks a shayla. V'lei tiknu ledeya hashniya zecha gam lamorer ha'mechel ma'seita. They did not make, according to the second day, that's a zecha to the matzah. So the Rebbe like asks, if it's a zecha to the Korban Pesach, so if I understand, but if it's a zecha to the matzah, they didn't eat only matzah with the Korban Pesach, they ate morer also. So why don't you make a zecha for morer? So he answers, kimish of his man she'ein pesach yuvel rak medarabon. Since when there is no Korban Pesach, it's only medarabon. So they didn't want to make a zecha, something it's only medarabon. And then the Rebbe adds, ein leimer hatam alita konezu. You cannot say it. Maybe the reason why they didn't make it hakonu to make a zecha to the morer that they ate with the Pesach. He called Iker Amorim in Atero Rak Machshir HaPesach, because the Morim Midaraisa is only for the Korban Pesach, it's a Machshir to the Pesach. Ve'ein a mitzvah b'pnei atzmei, and it's not a mitzvah for itself, you would think so. And he quotes the Rambam Hilchas Chametz Matzah, Resh Perek Zayin, Bechur is supposed to be Perek Zayin Alochim Beis, maybe it's a typing mistake. Anyway, the Rebbe says you can't say that the reason is, not because it's the Rabbanan, the reason is because it's not a mitzvah for itself, Bechlau. It's only a Machshir to the Pesach, so the Rebbe says that's not true. Because there is a chiyuv morer midaraisa, even if you're not mechuyev to the Korban Pesach. And he quotes, look at the psochim of Sadekala from the base, Kedushim Amzayin of the base, Teisefte psochim, Sofpeirik base, that's the sefte we mentioned before. And then he says, Sofnasnei of the Rakachover and the Ramba. So in this last piece, what he's trying to say is very clear, that even in the time that there is some in this Mikdash, if a person didn't eat the Korban Pesach, you might think so, Mele morer would be by him at the Rabbanon, because morer is only a machshir of the Pesach, and if you don't have the Pesach, then you're not mechuyev b'morer. He says it's not true. As long as it's the time of the Beis Hamikdash, when there is a Korban Pesach, you have to eat morer b'derais. Now this is negayah not only the way we hold, even according to Hillel. This will affect also what's in the pshat in Hillel's words. Hillel, we know, holds, when we say kenos Hillel, when we eat the Keirach, so Hillel holds, ein adam yetzei dechavasam lo quoting the Alter Rebbe's Lashon. You're not yetzim in the raisa, el imken keirach, unless you put together kazayis pesach, the kazayis morer, the kazayis matzah, the eichlum b'yachad. The only yetzim if you eat kazayis the pesach, kazayis the morer, and kazayis the matzah together. The kaim ashenemer to fulfill what it says, al matzah semreim yechlu. Because it says you have to eat them all together. That's what the sheet of Hillel is. So the Alter Rebbe writes there in Sifud Zayin, v'av bizman hazeh shemorer reine ele medivri sefer, mamatzim in atayra. And even nowadays, when morer is only with the rabbanon, and matzim the raisa in korcham yachad ba'ochlon ain yetsi di chavos afel das hillel. So nowadays, if you eat just the keirach matzah morer together, you're not yetsi even according to Hillel the mitzvah of matzah. Hillel said you have to eat the matzah and the morer and the korban pesach together. Nowadays, when we do keirach because you want to be yetsi hishita, you have to eat a separate kazayis matzah even according to Hillel. You're not yetzah with keirach that you ate the matzah and the morer, you yetzah the mitzvah matzah. And he says why? Because the morer is mevatel as tam matzah. The morer that you ate together with the matzah is mevatel at tam of the matzah. In kein chayivu lechel kazayis matzah bilvada b'lei morer. So even according to Hillel, you have to eat the kazayis matzah by itself without morer. Lot says he dechev as matzah min ha'teirah to the yetzah, the mitzvah matzah min ha'teirah. So according to what we said before, that when you didn't have the Korban Pesach with mana beis hamikdash, morer was midaraisa. So when without Rebbe says that according to Hillel you're not yetsa mitzvahs matzah, you did it together. Even according to Hillel, he meant only bizman hazeh, which there is no Pesach b'chlal. But in time of the beis hamikdash, even if someone didn't eat the Pesach, was yetsa the mitzvah of matzah if he ate it with the morer, because as we said before, those days even if you didn't eat the Korban Pesach bizman hamikdash, morer was midaraisa. And two mitzvahs that I said, not mevatel each other, but mele, according to Hillel, if they would eat bizman habayis, matzah, morer together, there was no problem. You can't say that the matzah, you're not yetzah matzah because the morer is mevatel, because morer is also mitaraisa. But the thing that we have to think about is to look into this. In the time of the Beis Hamikdash, when you didn't have the Korban Pesach, and you had to eat matzah mortar, the shaila is, were you mechuyev to eat the matzah with the mortar together, according to Hillel? Because you could say two things. On one hand, you could say, just like if there is a Korban Pesach, you have to eat the matzah and the mortar together with the Korban Pesach. So if you don't have a Korban Pesach, at least you have to eat the matzah and the mortar together. You don't have a Korban Pesach, you don't have a Korban Pesach. But since matzah is the raisa, mortar is the raisa, and the tamah mortar is not mevatel tamah matzah, because they're both the raisa, so you should eat them together like you ate if you have a Korban Pesach. But on the other hand, you could say, the whole union of eating mortar with the Korban Pesach, the chlal of mortar, is because the Pesach says, al matzahs umreirim yechluhu. You have to eat the Korban Pesach with matzah and mortar. But if there's no Korban Pesach, where is the rechiyuv to eat the matzah and the mortar together? Where do we get it from? But it's not so simple, on the other hand, because sof kol sof, we have no other posik that tells us the mitzvah of mortar. It's the only posik. And in this posik, it says that you ate the matzah with the mortar together. But sof kol sof, on the other hand, like I said, it's all your chluhu, it's the Korban Pesach. You don't have the Korban Pesach. Now, we could be medayik and d'alter Rebbe Shulchan Aruch that in those days they did eat the matzah and the mortar together according to Hillel. Because there again, the Alter Rebbe writes like this. Explains why do we have to eat kerev? We ate matzah. So matzah, we ate the mitzvah of matzah. Then we have to eat kerev, the matzah and the mortar together. So he says, according to Hillel, this is all because of Hillel. So we have to take again another piece of matzah, kazayis, you need it with the mortar. Why? Because mortar bizman hazeh tiknu chachomim zeicher lemikdosh. The mortar nowadays, they made a zeicher to the mikdosh. Shehoye os chiyuvim min ha-teira when it's min d'raise. O bizman shemis ha-mikdosh kayem, eine yeitze yidei chivas mortar min ha-teira lufidas hillel, alim kekerche na matzah. And at the time of the Beis Hamikdash, they were not yeitze the mitzvah of mortar unless they ate it with matzah. But then you had the Korban Pesach, it seems like they ate it with matzah. So now also, according to Hillel, you have to eat it together with the matzah. Now it's interesting. The Alter Rebbe doesn't write that bizman shebisamit nishkayim you were not yetze chayvas morer min atere unless you ate it with the Pesach and the matzah. That's what it is. In time of the Samikdash, you had to eat the morer together with the Korban Pesach and the matzah. Doesn't that write that? He says in the time of the Samikdash, according to Hillel, you were not yetze with morer. Unless you ate it with the matzah. And he doesn't mention the Korban Pesach here. So it seems very clear that in the time of the Beis Hamikdash, even if you didn't have the Korban Pesach, so you didn't eat it with the Korban Pesach, because you weren't chayiv, your tomei, whatever it is, but nevertheless, they ate it together, they ate the matzah together with the matzah. So l'chura, this is a raya, that's what they did then, that they had to eat the matzah and the matzah together, even though they didn't have a Korban Pesach. According to this, it comes as something interesting. You could say like a shtikl nubshat. When the Alter Rebbe writes according to Hillel, Shari bizmorer bizman hazeh tiknu chachomim zecher lemikdosh, shoy oschiyu manateira, that they wired to eat morer bizman hazeh, se zecher to the mikdosh, which then it was manateira. So the pshat will be, normally we learn that it's a zecher in the bizmorer mikdosh, since they had a Korban Pesach, so they ate the Pesach matzah morer together, so morer was midaraisa. And now it's only midrabbono, but it's a zecher to the mikdash when they ate the mortar together with the Korban Pesach and the matzah. But according to what we're saying now, you could say that he means it's a zecher le mikdash, not to the mikdash the normal way they ate matzah and mortar and the Korban Pesach. It's a zecher to the time of the Beis Hamikdash when they did not have the Korban Pesach. That just like in the time of the Beis Hamikdash when they did not have the Korban Pesach, if someone didn't have the Korban Pesach, had to eat the matzah and mortar together. That's what we're saying now that l'chura they did it together. So now there's a zecher l'mikdash to the way it was at the time when they did not have the Korban Pesach. And that's where it goes. That's how the hemshach will be. So this is what the Alter Rebbe means, zecher l'mikdash, not the way we learn kipshut, the zecher l'mikdash when they had ate the Korban Pesach. Zecher l'mikdash, it's a hemshach to the time when they did not have the Korban Pesach. And the truth is, we could say that even earlier, when the Alter Rebbe writes earlier, Mitzvah's mortar and a teir, any alob is man shapesach nechal. The mitzvah mortar with the rice is only in Pesach was eaten. Avel is man as any alob is sofrim, shetiknu zecha the migdash. Now, from the rabbon, it's a zecha to the migdash. So normally you would learn to zecha to the migdash when they have the Korban Pesach, they ate mortar. So nowadays it's a zecha to the migdash. It's not according to Hillel, this is even Bachlal. So here you could also say, When he says Zeichel LeMikdash, it doesn't mean Zeichel LeMikdash when they had the full thing. They had matzah, modern, and pesach. So modern was midaraisa. It's a Zeichel. To that, we eat modern now too. The Rabbonim are masakin modern nowadays as a Zeichel to what they did in the time of the Beis HaMikdash when a person did not have the Korban Pesach. And this has a certain maile, if you learn this pshat, the maile is that it's a real hemshech. Like this, and you say, it's my Beis HaMikdash, they ate the Korban Pesach. I would the Korban Pesach, they eat Morer. So it's a Zeichel LeMikdash that you eat Morer now too. So it's a different thing, because then it Morer was with the Korban Pesach. Now Morer is Morer by itself. So Kasha, what the Chachomim could do it if they want to, they could make any Tekon as they want. But if you learn that it's a Zeichel Chathila to the way it was when those people did not have the Korban Pesach, then it's Mamash a real Hemshech. They're saying exactly what happened then with the Raise, when there was no Din of, with no Korban Pesach, and there was still a Din Morer with the Raise. You had to eat the matzah and the Morer together. So now, the same thing, we don't have a Korban Pesach, and we have to eat together. With the Raise, you don't, because with Sof Kosov, there is no Pesach, but the Mitzias is the same as then. So it's only a Hemshech from the way it was then. So the Chura always fits that we do have to, they did have to eat the matzah and the morer together in the time of the Beis HaMikdash, even if they didn't eat the Korban Pesach. But the Chura, you can bring a Raya Farkir, opposite. Because the Chura, if we're going to say what we said before, then we have to really understand something the Alter Rebbe writes further in Sifut Ches. This is the Alter Rebbe's Losh. The meaning in these countries is, Leimer Kedem Achilus Krich Azu, before we eat Kerach, we say like this, Kein Oseh Hilo Bezmash Beis HaMikdash Kayam, or your keirach, matzah umorer. And then they would put together matzah and morer. So we too now do it. The Rebbe adds, ein maskirim pesach. We don't say that they is mashah b'samikdash kayim or your keirach pesach matzah umorer. Even though he says after hillel or your keirach gam kazayis matzah b'krichazu. Hillel did ate it together with the korban pesach, the korban kazayis pesach from b'krichazu. Ate it with the korban pesach. So why don't we do that? Why don't we mention pesach? He says. Since we're saying this is what he did. In other words, what we're doing is what he did. That's not true. But on Pesach, we're not doing that. We don't have a Korban Pesach. That's why we don't mention the Pesach. He says, if you do mention, it's no problem. As we'll see soon, in our Haggadah, we do mention Korban Pesach, and the Rebbe explains it, they will say soon. But we see what we see here is, when we say, we should have said, Pesach, matzah, morer, that's what he ate. Why don't you mention Pesach? So our answer is because we're not doing it. Fine. But the kasha was really, he should have said that Hillel ate keirach, Pesach, matzah, morer. B'chure, what's the kasha? Did Hillel always eat Pesach, matzah, morer? Take, when he was in the Beis HaMikdash, he ate Pesach, matzah, morer. What happened if Hillel was tamei? Or he was bederech racheika? And the truth is that for many years he lived in Bavel. And we don't know if he went up to the Beis HaMikdash from Bovel. He was definitely not chayiv because the din is that if you're living, where Tosfos says in Pesachim Daf Gimel, if you live in Chutz Laaretz, you don't have to have a lil regel, maybe you're potter from the Korban Pesach, the way Tosfos says there. So very possible and probable that Hillel many years did not go to Yerushalayim for Korban Pesach, where Pesach wasn't giving the Korban Pesach. So what did he do? It was Bizman Abayis. So he ate matzah and morer. If we said before that you have to eat even without the Korban Pesach, Bizman Abayis, you have to eat matzah morer together, so it's very fine. That's what we say. What he did was keirach matzah morer. We don't mention the Korban Pesach. So that's what I meant. So what's the reason for the Alter Rebbe asking a kasha? Why don't we mention Pesach? The embassy is, this is a kasha bichlal, even not because of Hillel. Bichlal is a kasha. Definitely, according to Hillel, those Yidden who did not eat the Korban Pesach, Bizman Abayis, and Hillel Atzmei maybe, so they ate the morer with the matzah, without the Korban Pesach. Why would we mention it, the Korban Pesach? B'chur is haraya that enoch aname. If they didn't have the Korban Pesach, they didn't eat matzah and morer together. But maybe we can't say it. That's why the Alter Rebbe asked, why don't you mention the Pesach? Because that's the only way they eat together. Alter Rebbe answered, because we're not doing it. So b'chur hashtikl raya that they did not have to eat the matzah and the morer together if they did not have the Korban Pesach. That means we could say it's not such a real raya that they didn't eat the matzah and the morer together if they didn't eat the Korban Pesach. Because after all, in most cases, most times, Hillel and most of the Eden ate it together with the Pesach. That's the right way to do it. The only reason they ate it on the Korban Pesach is because they're Tomei B'derech HaChayko. So, and sof kol sof, even then, why did they eat moreh midaraisa? Because there is korban pesach, not by them, but there is korban pesach. There is a korban pesach. There is a beis hamikdash korban pesach. The Meila, that's maybe the reason why the Alter Rebbe asks, why don't you mention pesach? Because the Peil Mamish, in most cases, they ate it with the pesach. But I think it's a deichlik because sof kol sof, what's wrong with saying keirach matzah moreh? Especially the way I'm saying that this whole thing that we're doing now is a hemshech, not to the people who ate the korban pesach. It's a hemshech to those people that did eat the korban pesach. So the chur is a shtika raya, but not a real raya that they did not eat the korban the matzah moreh together. But it's not clear. Chur from the Rebbe's Agoda, we could chur see a little bit that they did not have to eat the matzah moreh together when they didn't have the korban pesach. So the Rebbe writes in the Agoda like this, on the piece Kenos Hillel, he writes, We do say Keirach Pesach Matzah Moreh, that he put together Pesach and Matzah Moreh. And the Rebbe adds to this, the Ladasa Maforshim, Korten Maforshim, said the Rambam, Keinos Hillel, that's what Hillel did. The Im Yashmit Pesach, so the Rebbe said, if we skip the word Pesach, Yedaber Shkorin B'Sipura, you'll be lying. You'll be saying that he was Keirach Matzah Moreh without Pesach. It's not true. You're lying. He did it with the Korban Pesach. In other words, the reason he said, the Rebbe explains, the reason why does the Alter Rebbe in Haggadah, and you see that, put in the word, Pesach Matzah Moreh, different than he writes in his own Shulchan Aruch, because Lepeil, that's what Hillel did. Hillel put together Pesach Matzah Moreh, so you can't skip the word, because if you skip the word, you're lying. You're saying he ate Matzah Moreh, but he didn't. He ate Pesach Matzah Moreh. The Chura, but according to what we said before, but even the time of the Mishamikdash, even if he didn't eat the Korban Pesach, he still had to eat the Matzah Moreh together, then why is that a lie? And we say, Hillel, if we would say, Hillel ate together, put together, Matzah Moreh, without Pesach. Yeah, many times he did that. Why did the Rebbe say it's a lie? I many times ate it with the Korban Pesach, but still to say it's a lie when we're saying, especially what's negayah to us, is negayah that he ate the Matzah and the Moreh together. So the Chura is a shtikl raya from here that they did not eat it together. That's why they only ate matzah moreh together if there was Pesach. That's why the Rebbe says we have to say Pesach, because otherwise it's a lie. He never did it. He always ate together with the Pesach. On the other hand, again, I'm saying it's not a shtark, not a real raya, because maybe what the Rebbe means, that if he would say, oh, you keirach matzah moreh without the word Pesach, would be mashma that he always did it like that. And that's not true. He didn't always do it. Most times he ate it with the Pesach, with but we have to look into this to see how it is. But then there's another shaila. In the piece that the Rebbe writes on Keirach, the Rebbe writes like this. This is a lashon of the Rebbe. The das Hillel Azogin, according to Hillel, we have to follow the words carefully. There's a few cases here. He says like this. In time of Hillel, according to Hillel, Bisman sheyesh Pesach, when there is a korban Pesach, eine yeitze yidei chevoseh leimken Keirach Pesach matzah moreh melechem b'yachad. You're not yeitze. According to Hillel, unless you take the Pesach, the Matzah and the Moreh, you put it together, eat it together. That's if there is Pesach. There's a losh. Bizman sheyesh Pesach. Bizman she'ein Pesach, ein yetzei lechavos chevas matzah shum natera leichav b'fnei atzmei. If there is no Pesach, you're not yetzei. This according to Hillel, you're not yetzei matzah, which is the raisa, unless you eat matzah separately. And ein yetzei chevas moreh shetiknu chachamim zeichel lemikdash, and you're also not yetzei the mitzvah of moreh, which the Chachomim said as Eichah to the Mikdash, Elaim ken kercha yematzah veichon b'yachat mishosah b'zorah b'samikdash, unless you put the matzah together with the butter. So, according to Hillel, you have to eat matzah separately, and then you have to eat kerch. Now, when the Rebbe uses the Loshon, Bizman sheyesh Pesach, what does he mean? Does it mean a time when there is a Korban Pesach, Eilom's other people Korban Pesach, or it means when you're reading the Korban Pesach? It definitely means when you're reading the Korban Pesach. Because he says clearly, when there is Pesach, you're not yetzah yidechavoseh unless you put together the Pesach matzah moreh. So obviously he's talking a time when you actually ate the Korban Pesach. Now when you go to the second case, bisman she'ein Pesach, what would that mean? If bisman she'yesh Pesach means when you're eating the Pesach, bisman she'ein Pesach means when you're not eating the Pesach. That's why he continues. So if you're not eating the Pesach, which means as long as you're not eating the Pesach, even in the time with Beis Hamikdash, that's what he's saying. So what does he say here? That you're not yetzer. If you're not eating the Pesach, you're not yetzer chevas matzah, which is the raisa, unless you eat it separately. Why? If you're not eating the Pesach, but it's a time when there is a korban Pesach, moreh is the raisa. So if moreh is the raisa, then the mitzvah of moreh, mitzvah of matzah, one of them is not canceling out mevatel the other. So why aren't the yetzer mitzvah of matzah if there is no korban Pesach? So we must say that this party means if there is no Korban Pesach Be'etzem, when there is no Beis Hamikdash. But then it doesn't fit to the Reisha. There's a Reisha and a Sefer. The Reisha says the man sheyesh Pesach, and then the other side of the coin, man sheyesh Pesach. Now, man sheyesh Pesach means when you're actually eating the Pesach. Man sheyesh Pesach should mean when you're not eating Korban Pesach. But we're saying now, no, it means when there is no Korban Pesach at all. So you must say, yeah, maybe that's what it means, Takim. Man sheyesh Pesach means he's eating. Man sheyesh Pesach means not only we're not eating it, there is no Korban Pesach b'chlal, but the lashon doesn't fit. So, abyssal, it's a shvera zach. You've got to find an answer. Unless we're going to say that when the Rebbe says b'zman sheyesh Pesach, it doesn't mean only eating. Which is the derech. When there is a Korban Pesach means if you have it because you're eating it, or there is b'chlolos, there is Korban Pesach even though you don't have it. And the Rebbe is maybe there is a true diuk here because he says the loshen b'zman sheyesh Pesach. When there is a Korban Pesach. Why doesn't say this man sha'ichla Pesach? When you eat the Korban Pesach. Because he's talking about eating the Korban Pesach. He says you're only yetzi if you're kairach Pesach matzamore. Maybe he uses a lotion, this man sha'yesh Pesach, not say man sha'ichla. Can I tell you clearly, even though the chlola says when you eat the Korban Pesach, but there is also here a remez that as long as there is a Korban Pesach, then you're not yetzi the mitzvah of matzah. You eat it together with the you're yetzi if you eat them together. The time when there is Pesach, even though you're not eating it, you are yetzer the mitzvah of morer and the mitzvah of matzah, as long as if you eat them together, because the mitzvah of morer is not the time of morer is not mevatel the time of matzah, because it's both deraisa. That's negeya. This first thing in negeya. What was the seder when someone was tomer v'derech hacheika didn't have the Korban Pesach? Number one is morer mideraisa, which we showed it is, and also did you have to eat it together with the matzah? Now we'll go to the second thing. At the gate of Tutafshil. Says in the Gemara Psoch in the Kuf Kedalad, Omad Aleph, a view of fun of matzah, the chazeres, the chareses, the chnei tafshil, they would bring to the table the matzah and the morer, chareses, and the two tafshilim, the two foods. And the Mishnah says, Ubemigdosh hoi meviim lefon of Kufishal Pesach. In the Beis Hamikdosh, they would bring the Korban Pesach itself. Which means probably not the Dafkin the Beis Hamikdash, it means in Yerushalayim, where they eat the Korban Pesach, they would have both. And the Alter Rebbe Shulchan Aruch Siman Tov Ayin Gimel Sivchov writes like this, you have to be careful with the words. It's man she Beis Hamikdash Kayim, when he had a Beis Hamikdash, he had tzorich lohovi gamas ha-Pesach b'shaas ha-minas ha-godem. He had to bring the Pesach itself when he said ha-godem. Then the next words, v'achshav shechorav Beis Hamikdash. Now that the Beis Hamikdash is destroyed, tiknu chachomim. After the Beis Hamikdash was destroyed, the chachomim were misakim. That when you say the agode, you have to have on the table two types of tafshilin, echad zeicher the Pesach, the echad zeicher the gige. One is zeicher to the Pesach, one zeicher to the gige. So here it seems clearly from the Alter Rebbe, when did this takone start that you have to bring two tafshilin to the seder? He says the achshav shechorav beis hamikdash after churban beis hamikdash. Lechura, this seems to be complete opposite of what the Rebbe writes in the agode. The Rebbe in the piece where it says Hazreya v'Abeya, you have to have Hazreya and the Beya. So the Rebbe explains why do we need Hazreya and the Beya? Kitzar Chlias Shnei Tafshilin. We have to have two Tafshilin, Echad Zeicher the Pesach, Echad Zeicher the Tige. One Zeicher the Pesach, Tige. And then he says that Bamrinam Yerushalmi. In Yerushalmi it says Sheminek Lokachas Zreya u'Beya. It says that Bamrinam Zreya u'Beya. That's it. Then the Rebbe adds something interesting. Yes, Shekosu. There are some people who wrote the Lake Chimbeya. Why do we have to pick an egg? Since this happened only after the churban beis hamikdash, this takana, so they put a zeicher to churban, and we know eggs is a michael of avelim, so we have a zeicher to avelus of the churban beis hamikdash. The Rebbe asks a kasha, tzorich irtzas, the muchach b'mishnah b'Yerushalmi, it's obvious, he says, in the Mishnah in Yerushalmi, the gam b'zman beis hamikdash hoyu loikhin shnei tafshilin, that in the time of the beis hamikdash it took two tafshilin. Which means, obviously, if you didn't have the Korban Pesach, even the time of the Beis Hamikdash, but there was a Korban Pesach, but if you didn't have the Korban Pesach, because you were someplace else, you were Moderech Recheik, or you were Tomei, they also had two Tafshilin. And this was in time of the Beis Hamikdash, but also Zeicher L'Avelis, then they didn't make a Zeicher L'Avelis. So obviously, then they didn't have an egg. So it comes out, the Inkein, it's Farach Lever, we'll have to say, Asher Meir Shonim, hundreds of years, Lok Chumim, Achal Zeicher Avigir, hundreds of years till the churban, they took a different mean for the zecher of gigya. And after the churban, they changed it. And that's hard to say. Therefore, the Rebbe says He disagrees with the reason, those that write that the reason why we take an egg is Zechel Lavilus of the Churban. Then in the Miluyim of the Agoda, it's a letter that's to Harav Zevin, printed in Lekut Siches, Chedek Zayin, on Mishnah 257, the Igris, Chedek Beis, on the Reish Mem Gimel, Reish Samach. There, the Rebbe tells him, he asked the Rebbe, where do we see that they use the Teit of Shilim Bisman Abayis? So the Rebbe says, it's clearly, look at the Mishnah. And he quoted the Mishnah again. The Mishnah says, they brought in front of the person the matzah, chazer, chareis, and two tafshilin, and the mikdash shoy lefon of gufishol pesach, not in the time of the Beis HaMikdash. And if you were in the Beis HaMikdash, which means in Yerushalayim, you had the korban pesach itself. So obviously, we're saying, what did they do when if you were not in the Beis HaMikdash, you had shnei tafshilin, and if you were in the Beis HaMikdash, you had the korban pesach. This mashm is clearly not mashm, clearly. Then in time of the Beis HaMikdash, they also have to tafshil. And also brings the Yerushalmi, it says, in Perikyut, Sochem Perikyut, Sochem Noche Gimel, Ubigvulim Tzrichem Beis Tafshilim. And in the Gvulim means outside of Yerushalayim, you need to tafshilim. And when is Zeichel, Pesach, when is Zeichel, Yigil. And then he brings more protein. So he writes clearly that we see clearly that this minik or this takon of tafshilim happened before the Churban Beis HaMikdash. The Mela, the Rebbe has a kasha, if the whole reason of the egg is because of Avelos of the Churban, seems like all the years before that they ate something else, and here they changed it, it's a hard thing to say. But Lechura, based on that, what Alter Rebbe said before, yeah, it's a meredic kasha. Alter Rebbe says clearly, based on Shulchan, based on Shulchan. Says clearly, when does the Takonas Chachamim to have two Tafshilin on the table, Achav Churban Beis HaMikdash? And this is not someplace we have a kasha from a Sabavor, from the place, someplace you have a kasha. It's from the Alter Rebbe Shulchan this deal. Like this, some shaita would say, okay, you know, you say something and you forgot that there is a psalocha someplace. Chas v'sholem to say b'chlal, but in this case, it's on the place. In the place of Shulchan Aruch, where he talks about the Tut of Shilin. So how could someone forget that? So how could the Rebbe say that this happened, this was a takana before? There must be a very simple answer to this kasha. The stronger the kasha, the teretz must be simpler. The Rebbe used to say, when you have a klotzka, I used to call it a klotz kasha, very simple kasha, must be a very simple answer to this. It must be some mistake we're making here. Because otherwise, it's often a stira. Here, Alter Rebbe says that it happened, that takone, achshav shechor b'samikdash, tiknu chachomim, sheyi al shom tafshilin, and the Rebbe says clearly that it happened before. So the beer must be like this, very simple. There were two stages. That means like this. In the time of the Beis HaMikdash, if you didn't have the Korban Pesach, you would have there was a din that you have to put two tafshilin. One should be a zecher to the Korban Pesach. But we can't call it the Takonas Chachomim. After the Churban Beis HaMikdash, then we call it the Takonas Chachomim. Which means like this. In the time of the Beis HaMikdash, there was a mitzvah seser of Aliyah L'Regel. You had to go up to Yerushalayim beyond the Pesach. You had to bring the Korban Pesach. How could we say the Chachomim made a takone to do something Zeche, the way you do it in the Mikdash. This whole thing is not really the right thing to do. It's all about the Eved. Person is sick or old or doesn't have karka, like Taisa says in Psochim, Rav Gimel. So there you would not come to the Beis HaMikdash. Or if a person, okay, Tommy B'derech Chayko, this is not here in the Geya, but so it's all about the Eved. So how would we say there's a takonas chachomim about something that the chachomim really hoped it wouldn't happen? The truth is, what happens if there is such a mitzvah? So they had to tell you what to do. So they did tell you what to do. But you can't call it a takonas chachamim. Really, they wanted it should never happen. Everyone should go to Yerushalayim. Nevertheless, they still told people what should you do if you don't have it. In other words, if you want to say the different signal, the time of the Beis HaMikdash, it was a takone, but you can't call it a takone, takonas chachamim aklal yisrael. Takone on these individuals that didn't have the Korban Pesach for whatever reason. A takone on them, but it's not a real takone. After the churban, when it's the whole klal yisrael isn't that massive, then it's takone not only for yechidim, it's takone for all the yidim. So therefore, this is the pshat in the Alter Rebbe. I'll read the Alter Rebbe. I'll read it again. Bizman she Beis HaMikdash kayem, when the Beis HaMikdash existed, hoyo tzorich lohavi gamas haPesach v'shas amiras haGodel. They had to bring the Korban Pesach inside haGodel, which is saying what you had to do. In other words, what is the right way to do? He doesn't write what happens if you couldn't do that? What happens if you're in the time of the Beis HaMikdash and you couldn't bring the Korban Pesach? What's that negated to us? We have to, but we're saying what that was in the Beis HaMikdash. And then we have to know what's us. There was a time in the Beis HaMikdash. Why is that negeya? And then he says, "Va'achshav shachora Beis HaMikdash, not Beis HaMikdash destroyed." Tiknu chachomim. Now it's takonas chachomim sheyu al hashulchan shasaminus beis tavshilu nechazich al pesach veyachazich al chagiga. This is a takonas chachomim that he said. That means after the churban Beis HaMikdash, it became a chayv on every yid. That's what you have to do. That's called takonas chachomim. And that's what the Alter Rebbe means. Now that the Beis HaMikdash was destroyed, tiknu chachomim to tell you that this is a takonas chachomim. But nevertheless, before they also did it, not the bechinas takonas chachomim. So in the Mishnah, where the Mishnah does mention, as it seems that what they did, if they didn't have the Korban Pesach, as we said before, the Rebbe brings the Mishnah, they brought Shnei Tavshilin, and in the Mikdash they brought the Korban Pesach. Because the Mishnah is telling us, Bepeil, what did they do? And Bepeil, even outside of Yerushalayim, in the Zman HaBayis, they brought the Tavshilin, they ate mortar. And as the Rebbe uses the Lashon, Muchach Ma'amishim Yerushalayim. So Mele, the Rebbe's Machriach, for sure it was before. I doubt the Rebbe says after the Churban, that means as a takonah, but they did do it before. And that's what the Rebbe asked. It's hard to say that for many hundreds of years, they brought one thing and then they changed. And to add just to what the Rebbe says, because we could say that if they used the two tafshilin before, so the zecher lemikdash that we do now, that we brought the tafshilin, is not only a zecher to the Korban Pesach that they did. It's a zecher to what they did in the time of the Beis HaMikdash, if they didn't have a Korban Pesach, which they were exactly like we are. But then there was a Korban Pesach, similar to what I said in the other Inyan, that zecher l'mikdash doesn't mean zecher l'mikdash when they did it the 100% proper way. We're similar to the way it was not the proper way in the time of Beis HaMikdash, when they did not have a Korban Pesach. And that's what the Alter Rebbe means. And the Loshon of the Rebbe even is more meduyik. The Rebbe writes, Muchach v'mishneh v'yerushalmi, the Gam Bisman Bisamigdosh, Hoyu Lake Khishne Tafshilin. In time the Bisamigdosh, they took two Tafshilin. He doesn't write Chiyuv Chachomim or Tiknu Chachomim, because then it wasn't the Konas Chachomim. Even though the Chachomim probably told him what to do. After the Churban, it became the Konas Chachomim, a general Tekon. But we do have to understand, and again, that piece of the Rebbe, we need a little bit deeper. But the Rebbe says, what's the problem with saying the Zecher to Abelis? The Rebbe says, it's hard to say that many years, many hundreds of years, they used one thing for the Zecher Korban Pesach, and later, after the Churban, they changed it. What's so hard to say that before the Churban, there was no special meal that they had to take? Everyone could take whatever he wants. And not that, because it was not, as I said before, a real Takonas Chachamim. It was just telling you that if you don't have it, do something, so there was no separate meal. And then after the Churban Beis HaMikdash, the Chachamim were Masakin, a special meal, the meal of Bey, Zecher Lavit. And why is it hard to say that? The Rebbe says it's hard to say that before they used, if you're going to say they used before a specific mean, it was they said the Chum said you have to use something else, and now it came after the Churban, you're saying they changed it to an egg for Avelis. Then the Rebbe's Kasha, very strong Kasha. Well, they changed it because something was Kavua. But the Churban wasn't Kavua. They did whatever, they took whatever they wanted. When the Churban said, the Chum made a takonah. Many takonahs were made in the after the Churban Beis HaMikdash, the Chacham made a takonah. So why is that so hard to say? The Rebbe says it's a deichik to say that this was a change, and the reason is because of Avelis. The Churban is not going to change. The bottom line is the Rebbe shows a hofen that we should not only talk about the way it was in the time of Beis HaMikdash, but we should actually have the Beis HaMikdash and have the Korban Pesach and have the Chagiga, and no one will have to have the Teitav Shilin, because we're all being the Beis HaMikdash HaShlishi, the Meir B'Yameinu B'Korit Mamish.